Arnold Schwarzenegger. Full name, Arnold Aloysius Schwarzenegger. Height 1.88 m, weight 113 kilograms. Net worth, $400 million. Arnold Aloysius Schwarzenegger, born July 30, 1947, is an Austrian-American actor, filmmaker, businessman, author, philanthropist, activist, politician, and former professional bodybuilder and power lifter. He served as the 38th governor of California from 2003 to 2011. Schwarzenegger began lifting weights at the age of 15. He won the Mr. Universe title at age 20 and went on to win the Mr. Olympia contest 7 times, remaining a prominent presence in bodybuilding and writing many books and articles on the sport. The Arnold Sports Festival, considered the second most important professional bodybuilding event in recent years, is named after him. He is widely considered to be one of the greatest bodybuilders of all time, as well as the sport's most charismatic ambassador. Schwarzenegger gained worldwide fame as a Hollywood action film icon. His breakthrough film was the sword and sorcery epic Conan the Barbarian in 1982, a box office hit that resulted in a sequel. In 1984, he appeared in the title role of James Cameron's critically and commercially successful science fiction thriller film The Terminator. He subsequently played a similar Terminator character in most of the franchise's later installments, Terminator 2, Judgment Day, 1991, Terminator 3, Rise of the Machines, 2003, Terminator Genesis, 2015, and the upcoming Terminator, Dark Fate, 2019. He has appeared in a number of other successful films, such as Commando, 1985, The Running Man, 1987, Predator, 1987, Twins, 1988, Total Recall, 1990, Kindergarten Cop, 1990, and True Lies, 1994. Schwarzenegger married Maria Shriver, a niece of the 35th U.S. President John F. Kennedy and daughter of the 1972 Democratic vice presidential candidate and former ambassador to France Sergeant Shriver, in 1986. They separated in 2011 after he admitted to having fathered a child with another woman in 1997. As a Republican, Schwarzenegger was first elected on October 7, 2003, in a special recall election to replace then-Governor Gray Davis. He was sworn in on November 17, to serve the remainder of Davis' term. He was then re-elected in the 2006 California gubernatorial election, to serve a full term as Governor. In 2011, he completed his second term as governor and returned to acting. Schwarzenegger was nicknamed the Austrian Oak in his bodybuilding days, Arnie or Schwarzy during his acting career, and the Governator, a portmanteau of Governor and Terminator, during his political career. Early life. Arnold Aloysius Schwarzenegger was born on July 30, 1947, in Thal, Styria, to Aurelia, Najadrini. 1922-1998, and Gustav Schwarzenegger, 1907-1972, his father was the local chief of police and had served in World War II as a Hauptfeldwebel after voluntarily joining the Nazi Party in 1938. Was wounded during the Battle of Stalingrad, but was discharged in 1943 following a bout of malaria. He married Schwarzenegger's mother on October 20, 1945, He was 38 and she was 23. According to Arnold Schwarzenegger, his parents were very strict. Back then in Austria it was a very different world. If we did something bad or we disobeyed our parents, the rod was not spared. He grew up in a Catholic family who attended Mass every Sunday. Gustav had a preference for his elder son, Meinhard, over Arnold. His favoritism was strong and blatant, which stemmed from unfounded suspicion that Arnold was not his biological child. Schwarzenegger has said that his father had no patience for listening or understanding your problems. He had a good relationship with his mother and kept in touch with her until her death. In later life, he commissioned the Simon Wiesenthal Center to research his father's wartime record, which came up with no evidence of Gustav being involved in atrocities. Despite his membership in the Nazi Party and Sturmabteilung, SA, Gustav's background received wide press attention during the 2003 California recall campaign. At school, Schwarzenegger was reportedly academically average, but stood out for his cheerful, good-humored, and exuberant character. Money was a problem in their household. Schwarzenegger recalled that one of the highlights of his youth was when the family bought a refrigerator. As a boy, he played several sports, heavily influenced by his father. He picked up his first barbell in 1960, when his soccer coach took his team to a local gym. At the age of 14, he chose bodybuilding over soccer as a career. He later said, "I actually started weight training when I was 15, but I'd been participating in sports, like soccer, for years, so I felt that although I was slim, I was well developed. At least enough so that I could start going to the gym and start Olympic lifting." However, his official website biography claims that at 14, he started an intensive training program with Dan Farmer, studied psychology at 15, to learn more about the power of mind over body, and at 17, officially started his competitive career. During a speech in 2001, he said, "My own plan formed when I was 14 years old. My father had wanted me to be a police officer like he was. My mother wanted me to go to trade school." Schwarzenegger took to visiting a gym in Graz, where he also frequented the local movie theaters to see bodybuilding idols such as Reg Park, Steve Reeves, and Johnny Weissmuller on the big screen. When Reeves died in 2000, Schwarzenegger fondly remembered him, "As a teenager, I grew up with Steve Reeves. His remarkable accomplishments allowed me a sense of what was possible when others around me didn't always understand my dreams. Steve Reeves has been part of everything I've ever been fortunate enough to achieve." In 1961, Schwarzenegger met former Mr. Austria Kurt Marnull, who invited him to train at the gym in Graz. He was so dedicated as a youngster that he broke into the local gym on weekends, so that he could train even when it was closed. "It would make me sick to miss a workout. I knew I couldn't look at myself in the mirror the next morning if I didn't do it." When Schwarzenegger was asked about his first movie experience as a boy, he replied, "I was very young, but I remember my father taking me to the Austrian theaters and seeing some newsreels. The first real movie I saw, that I distinctly remember, was a John Wayne movie." Schwarzenegger's brother, Meinhard, died in a car crash on May 20, 1971. He was driving drunk and died instantly. Schwarzenegger did not attend his funeral. Meinhard was engaged to Erika Knapp, and they had a 3-year-old son named Patrick. Schwarzenegger paid for Patrick's education and helped him to move to the U.S. Gustav died on December 13, 1972, from a stroke. In Pumping Iron, Schwarzenegger claimed that he did not attend his father's funeral because he was training for a bodybuilding contest. Later, he and the film's producer said the story was taken from another bodybuilder to show the extremes some would go to for their sport and to make Schwarzenegger's image colder to create. Controversy fourth film. However, Barbara Baker, his first serious girlfriend, recalled that he informed her of his father's death without emotion and that he never spoke of his brother. Over time, he has given at least 3 versions of why he was absent from his father's funeral. In an interview with Fortune in 2004, Schwarzenegger told how he suffered what would now be called child abuse at the hands of his father. "My hair was pulled. I was hit with belts. So was the kid next door. It was just the way it was. Many of the children I've seen were broken by their parents, which was the German-Austrian mentality. They didn't want to create an individual. It was all about conforming. I was one who did not conform, and whose will could not be broken. Therefore, I became a rebel. Every time I got hit, and every time someone said, 'You can't do this,' I said, 'This is not going to be for much longer because I'm going to move out of here. I want to be rich. I want to be somebody.'" Schwarzenegger served in the Austrian army in 1965 to fulfill the 1 year of service required at the time of all 18-year-old Austrian males. During his army service, he won the Junior Mr. Europe contest. He went AWOL during basic training so he could take part in the competition and then spent a week in military prison. "Participating in the competition meant so much to me that I didn't carefully think through the consequences." He entered another bodybuilding contest in Graz, at Steirerhof Hotel, where he placed second. He was voted best built man of Europe, which made him famous in bodybuilding circles. "The Mr. Universe title was my ticket to America, the land of opportunity, where I could become a star and get rich." Schwarzenegger made his first plane trip in 1966, attending the NABBA Mr. Universe competition in London. He would come in second in the Mr. Universe competition, not having the muscle definition of American winner Chester Yurton. Charles Wag Bennett, one of the judges at the 1966 competition, was impressed with Schwarzenegger and he offered to coach him. As Schwarzenegger had little money, Bennett invited him to stay in his crowded family home above one of his two gyms in Forest Gate, London. Yurton's leg definition had been judged superior, and Schwarzenegger, under a training program devised by Bennett, concentrated on improving the muscle definition and power in his legs. Staying in the East End of London helped Schwarzenegger improve his rudimentary grasp of the English language. Living with the Bennetts also changed him as a person. "Being with them made me so much more sophisticated. When you're the age I was then, you're always looking for approval, for love, for attention, and also for guidance. At the time, I wasn't really aware of that. But now, looking back, I see that the Bennett family fulfilled all those needs. Especially my need to be the best in the world. To be recognized and to feel unique and special. They saw that I needed that care and attention and love." Also in 1966, while at Bennett's home, Schwarzenegger had the opportunity to meet childhood idol Reg Park, who became his friend and mentor. The training paid off and, in 1967, Schwarzenegger won the title for the first time, becoming the youngest ever Mr. Universe at the age of 20. He would go on to win the title a further 3 times. Schwarzenegger then flew back to Munich, where he attended a business school and worked in a health club, Rolf Putziger's gym, where he worked and trained from 1966 to 1968, returning in 1968 to London to win his next Mr. Universe title. 20 He frequently told Roger C. Field, his English coach and friend in Munich at that time, "I'm going to become the greatest actor." Schwarzenegger, who dreamed of moving to the US since the age of 10, and saw bodybuilding as the avenue through which to do so, realized his dream by moving to the United States in October 1968 at the age of 21, speaking little English. There he trained at Gold's Gym in Venice, Los Angeles, California, under Joe Weider's supervision. From 1970 to 1974, one of Schwarzenegger's weight training partners was Rick Drazin, a professional wrestler who designed the original Gold's Gym logo in 1973. Schwarzenegger also became good friends with professional wrestler superstar Billy Graham. In 1970, at age 23, he captured his first Mr. Olympia title in New York, and would go on to win the title a total of 7 times. The immigration law firm Siskind and Susser has stated that Schwarzenegger may have been an illegal immigrant at some point in the late 1960s or early 1970s because of violations in the terms of his visa. LA Weekly would later say in 2002 that Schwarzenegger is the most famous immigrant in America, who overcame a thick Austrian accent and transcended the unlikely background of bodybuilding to become the biggest movie star in the world in the 1990s. In 1977, Schwarzenegger's autobiography/weight training guide Arnold, The Education of a Bodybuilder became a huge success. In 1977 he posed for the gay magazine After Dark. After taking English classes at Santa Monica College in California, he earned a bachelor's degree by correspondence from the University of Wisconsin-Superior in International Marketing of Fitness and Business Administration in 1979. He got his United States citizenship in 1983. Schwarzenegger said that during this time he encountered a friend who told him he was teaching Transcendental Meditation, TM, which prompted Schwarzenegger to reveal that he had been struggling with anxiety for the first time in his life. "Even today, I still benefit from the year of TM because I don't merge and bring things together and see everything as one big problem." Bodybuilding career. Schwarzenegger is considered among the most important figures in the history of bodybuilding, and his legacy is commemorated in the Arnold Classic annual bodybuilding competition. He has remained a prominent face in bodybuilding long after his retirement, in part because of his ownership of gyms and fitness magazines. He has presided over numerous contests and awards shows. For many years, he wrote a monthly column for the bodybuilding magazines Muscle and Fitness and Flex. Shortly after being elected governor, he was appointed the executive editor of both magazines, in a largely symbolic capacity. The magazines agreed to donate $250,000 a year to the governor's various physical fitness initiatives. When the deal, including the contract that gave Schwarzenegger at least $1 million a year, was made public in 2005, many criticized it as being a conflict of interest, since the governor's office made decisions concerning regulation of dietary supplements in California. Consequently, Schwarzenegger relinquished the executive editor role in 2005. American Media Incorporated, which owns Muscle and Fitness and Flex, announced in March 2013 that Schwarzenegger had accepted their renewed offer to be executive editor of the magazines. One of the first competitions he won was the Junior Mr. Europe contest in 1965. He won Mr. Europe the following year, at age 19. He would go on to compete in many bodybuilding contests, and win most of them. His bodybuilding victories included 5 Mr. Universe wins, 4, NABBA England, 1, IFBB USA, and 7 Mr. Olympia wins. A record which would stand until Lee Haney won his 8th consecutive Mr. Olympia title in 1991. Schwarzenegger continues to work out. When asked about his personal training during the 2011 Arnold Classic, he said that he was still working out a half an hour with weights every day. Powerlifting. Weightlifting during Schwarzenegger's early years in bodybuilding. He also competed in several Olympic weightlifting and powerlifting contests. Schwarzenegger's first professional competition was in 1963, and he won 2 weightlifting contests in 1964 and 1965, as well as 2 powerlifting contests in 1966 and 1968. In 1967, Schwarzenegger won the Munich Stone Lifting Contest, in which a stone weighing 508 German pounds, 254 kilograms 560 pounds, is lifted between the legs while standing on 2 footrests. Personal records clean and press, 264 pounds, 120 kilograms. Snatch, 243 pounds, 110 kilograms, clean and jerk, 298 pounds, 135 kilograms. Squat, 545 pounds, 247 kilograms, bench press, 520 pounds, 240 kilograms. Deadlift, 710 pounds, 320 kilograms, Schwarzenegger, pictured with 1987 world champion American Karen Marshall, presenting awards at the USA Weightlifting Hall of Fame in 2011 in Columbus, Ohio. Mr. Olympia Schwarzenegger's goal was to become the greatest bodybuilder in the world, which meant becoming Mr. Olympia. His first attempt was in 1969. When he lost to three-time champion Sergio Oliva. However, Schwarzenegger came back in 1970 and won the competition, making him the youngest ever Mr. Olympia at the age of 23. A record he still holds to this day. He continued his winning streak in the 1971-74 competitions. In 1975, Schwarzenegger was once again in top form, and won the title for the sixth consecutive time, beating Franco Colombo. After the 1975 Mr. Olympia contest, Schwarzenegger announced his retirement from professional bodybuilding. Months before the 1975 Mr. Olympia contest, filmmakers George Butler and Robert Fiore persuaded Schwarzenegger to compete. In order to film his training in the bodybuilding documentary called Pumping Iron, Schwarzenegger had only 3 months to prepare for the competition, after losing significant weight to appear in the film Stay Hungry with Jeff Bridges. Although significantly taller and heavier, Lou Ferrigno proved not to be a threat, and a lighter than usual Schwarzenegger convincingly won the 1975 Mr. Olympia. Schwarzenegger came out of retirement, however, to compete in the 1980 Mr. Olympia. Schwarzenegger was training for his role in Conan, and he got into such good shape because of the running, horseback riding, and sword training, that he decided he wanted to win the Mr. Olympia contest one last time. He kept this plan a secret in the event that a training accident would prevent his entry and cause him to lose face. Schwarzenegger had been hired to provide color commentary for network television when he announced at the 11th hour that, while he was there, why not compete? Schwarzenegger ended up winning the event with only 7 weeks of preparation. Having been declared Mr. Olympia for a seventh time, Schwarzenegger then officially retired from competition. This victory, subject of the documentary The Comeback, was highly controversial, though, as fellow competitors and many observers felt that his lack of muscle mass, especially in his thighs, and subpar conditioning shouldn't have allowed him to come ahead of a very competitive lineup. That year, Mike Mentzer, in particular, felt cheated and withdrew from competitive bodybuilding after that contest. Steroid use. Schwarzenegger has admitted to using performance-enhancing anabolic steroids while they were illegal, writing in 1977 that steroids were helpful to me in maintaining muscle size while on a strict diet in preparation for a contest. I did not use them for muscle growth, but rather for muscle maintenance when cutting up. He has called the drugs tissue building. In 1999, Schwarzenegger sued Willy Heep, a German doctor who publicly predicted his early death on the basis of a link between his steroid use and his later heart problems. As the doctor had never examined him personally, Schwarzenegger collected a $10,000 libel judgment against him in a German court. In 1999, Schwarzenegger also sued and settled with Globe, a U.S. tabloid which had made similar predictions about the bodybuilder's future health. List of competitions, year, competition, location, result and notes. 1965 Junior Mr. Europe Germany first. 1966 Best Built Man of Europe Germany first. 1966 Mr. Europe Germany first. 1966 International Powerlifting Championship Germany first. 1966 NABA Mr. Universe Amateur London second to Chet Yurton. 1967 NABA Mr. Universe Amateur London first. 1968 NABA Mr. Universe Professional London first. 1968 German Powerlifting Championship Germany first. 1968 IFBB Mr. International Mexico first. 1968 IFBB Mr. Universe Florida second to Frank Zane. 1969 IFBB Mr. Universe Amateur New York first. 1969 NABA Mr. Universe Professional London first. 1969 Mr. Olympia New York second to Sergio Oliva. 1970 NABA Mr. Universe Professional London first, defeated his idol Rake Park. 1970 AAU Mr. World Columbus Ohio first, defeated Sergio Oliva for the first time. 1970 Mr. Olympia New York first. 1971 Mr. Olympia Paris first. 1972 Mr. Olympia Essen, Germany first. 1973 Mr. Olympia New York first. 1974 Mr. Olympia New York first. 1975 Mr. Olympia Pretoria, South Africa first, subject of the documentary Pumping Iron. 1980 Mr. Olympia Sydney, Australia first, subject of the documentary The Comeback. Competitive stats: height, 6 feet 2 inches, 188 centimeters. Contest weight, 235 pounds, 107 kilograms, the lightest in 1980 Mr. Olympia, around 225 pounds, 102 kilograms, the heaviest in 1974 Mr. Olympia, around 250 pounds, 113 kilograms. Off-season weight, 260 pounds, 118 kilograms. Chest, 57 in, 140 centimeters, waist, 34 in, 86 centimeters. Arms, 22 in, 56 centimeters, thighs, 28.5 in, 72 centimeters. Calves, 20 in, 51 centimeters, acting career. Early roles: Schwarzenegger wanted to move from bodybuilding into acting, finally achieving it when he was chosen to play the role of Hercules in 1969's Hercules in New York. Credited under the stage name Arnold Strong. His accent in the film was so thick that his lines were dubbed after production. His second film appearance was as a deaf-mute mob hitman in The Long Goodbye, 1973, which was followed by a much more significant part in the film Stay Hungry, 1976, for which he won the Golden Globe Award for New Star of the Year, Actor. Schwarzenegger has discussed his early struggles in developing his acting career. "It was very difficult for me in the beginning. I was told by agents and casting people that my body was too weird, that I had a funny accent, and that my name was too long. You name it, and they told me I had to change it. Basically, everywhere I turned, I was told that I had no chance." Schwarzenegger drew attention and boosted his profile in the bodybuilding film Pumping Iron, 1977, elements of which were dramatized. In 1991, he purchased the rights to the film, its outtakes and associated still photography. In 1977, he made guest appearances in single episodes of the ABC sitcom The San Pedro Beach Bums and the ABC police procedural The Streets of San Francisco. Schwarzenegger auditioned for the title role of The Incredible Hulk, but did not win the role because of his height. Later, Lou Ferrigno got the part of Dr. David Banner's alter ego. Schwarzenegger appeared with Kirk Douglas and Anne Margaret in the 1979 comedy The Villain. In 1980, he starred in a biographical film of the 1950s actress Jane Mansfield as Mansfield's husband, Mickey Hargitay. Action superstar Schwarzenegger's breakthrough film was the sword and sorcery epic Conan the Barbarian in 1982, which was a box office hit. This was followed by a sequel, Conan the Destroyer, in 1984. Although it was not as successful as its predecessor. In 1983, Schwarzenegger starred in the promotional video, Carnival in Rio. In 1984, he made his first appearance as the eponymous character, and what some would say was his acting career's signature role, in James Cameron's science fiction thriller film The Terminator. Following this, Schwarzenegger made Red Sonja in 1985. During the 1980s, audiences had an appetite for action films, with both Schwarzenegger and Sylvester Stallone becoming international stars. Schwarzenegger's roles reflected his sense of humor, separating him from more serious action hero films. He made a number of successful action films in the 1980s, such as Commando, 1985, Raw Deal, 1986, The Running Man, 1987, Predator, 1987, and Red Heat, 1988. Twins, 1988, a comedy with Danny DeVito, also proved successful. Total Recall, 1990, netted Schwarzenegger $10 million, equivalent to $19.2 million today, and 15% of the film's gross. A science fiction script, the film was based on the Philip K. Dick short story We Can Remember It For You Wholesale. Kindergarten Cop, 1990, reunited him with director Ivan Reitman, who directed him in Twins. Schwarzenegger had a brief foray into directing, first with a 1990 episode of the TV series Tales from the Crypt, entitled The Switch, and then with the 1992 telemovie Christmas in Connecticut. He has not directed since. Schwarzenegger's commercial peak was his return as the title character in 1991's Terminator 2, Judgment Day, which was the highest-grossing film of 1991. In 1993, the National Association of Theater Owners named him the International Star of the Decade. His next film project, the 1993 self-aware action comedy spoof Last Action Hero, was released opposite Jurassic Park, and did not do well at the box office. His next film, the comedy drama True Lies, 1994, was a popular spy film and saw Schwarzenegger reunited with James Cameron. That same year, the comedy Junior was released, the last of Schwarzenegger's three collaborations with Ivan Reitman and again co-starring Danny DeVito. This film brought him his second Golden Globe nomination, this time for Best Actor, Motion Picture Musical or Comedy. It was followed by the action thriller Eraser, 1996, the Christmas comedy Jingle All the Way, 1996, and the comic book-based Batman and Robin, 1997, in which he played the villain Mr. Freeze. This was his final film before taking time to recuperate from a back injury. Following the critical failure of Batman and Robin, his film career and box office prominence went into decline. He returned with the supernatural thriller End of Days, 1999, later followed by the action films The Sixth Day, 2000, and Collateral Damage, 2002, both of which failed to do well at the box office. In 2003, he made his third appearance as the title character in Terminator 3, Rise of the Machines, which went on to earn over $150 million domestically, equivalent to $204 million today. In tribute to Schwarzenegger in 2002, Forum Stott Park, a local cultural association, proposed plans to build a 25-meter-tall, 80-feet, Terminator statue in a park in central Graz. Schwarzenegger reportedly said he was flattered, but thought the money would be better spent on social projects and the Special Olympics. Retirement. His film appearances after becoming Governor of California included a 3-second cameo appearance in The Rundown, and the 2004 remake of Around the World in 80 Days. In 2005, he appeared as himself in the film The Kid and I. He voiced Baron von Steuben in the Liberty's Kids episode Valley Forge. He had been rumored to be appearing in Terminator Salvation as the original T-800. He denied his involvement, but he ultimately did appear briefly via his image being inserted into the movie from stock footage of the first Terminator movie. Schwarzenegger appeared in Sylvester Stallone's The Expendables, where he made a cameo appearance. Returned to acting in January 2011, just weeks after leaving office in California, Schwarzenegger announced that he was reading several new scripts for future films. One of them being the World War II action drama With Wings as Eagles, written by Randall Wallace, based on a true story. On March 6, 2011, at the Arnold Seminar of the Arnold Classic, Schwarzenegger revealed that he was being considered for several films, including sequels to The Terminator and remakes of Predator and The Running Man, and that he was packaging a comic book character. The character was later revealed to be the Governator, star of the comic book and animated series of the same name. Schwarzenegger inspired the character and co-developed it with Stan Lee, who would have produced the series. Schwarzenegger would have voiced the Governator. On May 20, 2011, Schwarzenegger's Entertainment Council announced that all movie projects currently in development were being halted. Schwarzenegger is focusing on personal matters and is not willing to commit to any production schedules or timelines. On July 11, 2011, it was announced that Schwarzenegger was considering a comeback film, despite the legal problems related to his divorce. He appeared in The Expendables 2, 2012, 70 and starred in The Last Stand, 2013, his first leading role in 10 years, and Escape Plan, 2013, his first co-starring role alongside Sylvester Stallone. He starred in Sabotage, released in March 2014, and appeared in The Expendables 3, released in August 2014. He starred in the fifth Terminator movie Terminator Genisys in 2015 and would reprise his role as Conan the Barbarian in The Legend of Conan, later renamed Conan the Conqueror. However, in April 2017, producer Chris Morgan stated that Universal had dropped the project, although there was a possibility of a TV show. The story of the film was supposed to be set 30 years after the first, with some inspiration from Clint Eastwood's Unforgiven. In August 2016, his filming of action comedy Why We're Killing Gunter was temporarily interrupted by bank robbers near filming location in Surrey, British Columbia. He was announced to star and produce in a film about the ruins of Sangzingdui called The Guest of Sangzingdui, as an ambassador. On February 6, 2018, Amazon Studios announced they were working with Schwarzenegger to develop a new series entitled Outrider, in which he will star and executive produce. The Western drama set in the Oklahoma Indian Territory in the late 1800s will follow a deputy, portrayed by Schwarzenegger, who is tasked with apprehending a legendary outlaw in the wilderness but is forced to partner with a ruthless federal marshal to make sure justice is properly served. The series will also mark as Schwarzenegger's first major scripted TV role. Schwarzenegger is to return in a Terminator film on November 1, 2019. The series co-creator James Cameron is producing the film, with Tim Miller as director. It is another cooperation with Cameron, who directed him previously in Terminator, Terminator 2, Judgment Day and True Lies. The film is planned as a direct sequel to Terminator 2 and disregards the storylines established with Terminator 3, Rise of the Machines, Terminator Salvation, and Terminator Genisys. It was shot in Almeria, Hungary, and the US. The Celebrity Apprentice in September 2015, the media announced that Schwarzenegger was to replace Donald Trump as host of the new Celebrity Apprentice. This show, the 15th season of The Apprentice, aired during the 2016 to 2017 TV season. In the show, he used the phrases "you're terminated" and "get to the choppa," which are quotes from some of his famous roles, The Terminator and Predator, respectively, when firing the contestants citation needed. In March 2017, following repeated criticisms from Trump, Schwarzenegger announced that he would not return for another season on the show. Schwarzenegger had reacted to Trump's latest remarks in January 2017 via an Instagram clip, "Hey, Donald, I have a great idea. Why don't we switch jobs? You take over TV because you're such an expert in ratings, and I take over your job, and then people can finally sleep comfortably again." Political career. Early politics. Schwarzenegger has been a registered Republican for many years. When he was an actor, his political views were always well known, as they contrasted with those of many other prominent Hollywood stars, who are generally considered to be a liberal and Democratic-leaning community. At the 2004 Republican National Convention, Schwarzenegger gave a speech and explained he was a Republican because the Democrats of the 1960s sounded too much like Austrian socialists. "I finally arrived here in 1968. What a special day it was. I remember I arrived here with empty pockets but full of dreams, full of determination, full of desire." The presidential campaign was in full swing. "I remember watching the Nixon-Humphrey presidential race on TV. A friend of mine who spoke German and English translated for me. I heard Humphrey saying things that sounded like socialism, which I had just left. But then I heard Nixon speak. He was talking about free enterprise, getting the government off your back, lowering the taxes and strengthening the military. Listening to Nixon speak sounded more like a breath of fresh air. I said to my friend, I said, 'What party is he?' My friend said, 'He's a Republican.' I said, 'Then I am a Republican. And I have been a Republican ever since." In 1985, Schwarzenegger appeared in Stop the Madness, an anti-drug music video sponsored by the Reagan administration. He first came to wide public notice as a Republican during the 1988 presidential election, accompanying then-Vice President George H.W. Bush at a campaign rally. Schwarzenegger's first political appointment was as chairman of the President's Council on Physical Fitness and Sports, on which he served from 1990 to 1993. He was nominated by George H.W. Bush, who dubbed him Conan the Republican. He later served as chairman for the California Governor's Council on Physical Fitness and Sports under Governor Pete Wilson. Between 1993 and 1994, Schwarzenegger was a Red Cross ambassador, a ceremonial role fulfilled by celebrities, recording several television and radio public service announcements to donate blood. In an interview with Talk magazine in late 1999, Schwarzenegger was asked if he thought of running for office. He replied, "I think about it many times. The possibility is there because I feel it inside." The Hollywood Reporter claimed shortly after that Schwarzenegger sought to end speculation that he might run for governor of California. Following his initial comments, Schwarzenegger said, "I'm in show business. I am in the middle of my career. Why would I go away from that and jump into something else?" Governor of California Arnold Schwarzenegger is a moderate Republican. He says he is fiscally conservative and socially liberal. On the issue of abortion, he describes himself as pro-choice, but supports parental notification for minors and a ban on partial birth abortion. He has supported gay rights, such as domestic partnerships, and he performed a same-sex marriage as governor. Schwarzenegger announced his candidacy in the 2003 California recall election for governor of California on the August 6, 2003, episode of The Tonight Show with Jay Leno. Schwarzenegger had the most name recognition in a crowded field of candidates, but he had never held public office and his political views were unknown to most Californians. His candidacy immediately became national and international news, with media outlets dubbing him the Governator, referring to the Terminator movies. See above, and The Running Man, the name of another one of his films, and calling the recall election Total Recall, yet another movie starring Schwarzenegger. Schwarzenegger declined to participate in several debates with other recall replacement candidates, and appeared in only one debate on September 24, 2003. On October 7, 2003, the recall election resulted in Governor Gray Davis being removed from office with 55.4% of the yes vote in favor of a recall. Schwarzenegger was elected governor of California under the second question on the ballot with 48.6% of the vote to choose a successor to Davis. Schwarzenegger defeated Democrat Cruz Bustamante, fellow Republican Tom McClintock, and others. His nearest rival, Bustamante, received 31% of the vote. In total, Schwarzenegger won the election by about 1.3 million votes. Under the regulations of the California Constitution, no runoff election was required. Schwarzenegger was the second foreign-born governor of California after Irish-born Governor John G. Downey in 1862. Schwarzenegger was entrenched in what he considered to be his mandate in cleaning up gridlock. Building on a catchphrase from the sketch Hans and Franz from Saturday Night Live, which partly parroted his bodybuilding career, Schwarzenegger called the Democratic state politicians girly men. Schwarzenegger's early victories included repealing an unpopular increase in the vehicle registration fee as well as preventing driver's licenses being given out to illegal immigrants. But later he began to feel the backlash when powerful state unions began to oppose his various initiatives. Key among his reckoning with political realities was a special election he called in November 2005, in which four ballot measures he sponsored were defeated. Schwarzenegger accepted personal responsibility for the defeats and vowed to continue to seek consensus for the people of California. He would later comment that no one could win if the opposition raised $160 million to defeat you. The U.S. Supreme Court later found the public employee union's use of compulsory fundraising during the campaign had been illegal in Knox v. Service Employees International Union, Local 1000. Schwarzenegger, against the advice of fellow Republican strategists, appointed a Democrat, Susan Kennedy, as his chief of staff. He gradually moved towards a more politically moderate position, determined to build a winning legacy with only a short time to go until the next gubernatorial election. Schwarzenegger ran for re-election against Democrat Phil Angelides, the California state treasurer, in the 2006 elections, held on November 7, 2006. Despite a poor year nationally for the Republican Party, Schwarzenegger won re-election with 56% of the vote compared with 38.9% for Angelides, a margin of well over 1 million votes. Around this time, many commentators saw Schwarzenegger as moving away from the right and towards the center of the political spectrum. After hearing a speech by Schwarzenegger at the 2006 Martin Luther King Jr. Day breakfast, in which Schwarzenegger said, "In part how wrong I was when I said everyone has an equal opportunity to make it in America, the state of California does not provide equal education for all of our children." San Francisco Mayor Gavin Newsom said that he's becoming a Democrat, he's running back, not even to the center. I would say center left. Some speculated that Schwarzenegger might run for the United States Senate in 2010, as his governorship would be term limited by that time. Such rumors turned out to be false. Wendy Lee, who wrote an unofficial biography on Schwarzenegger, claims he plotted his political rise from an early age using the movie business and bodybuilding as the means to escape a depressing home. Lee portrays Schwarzenegger as obsessed with power and quotes him as saying, I wanted to be part of the small percentage of people who were leaders, not the large mass of followers. I think it is because I saw leaders use 100% of their potential. I was always fascinated by people in control of other people. Schwarzenegger has said that it was never his intention to enter politics, but he says, "I married into a political family. You get together with them and you hear about policy, about reaching out to help people. I was exposed to the idea of being a public servant and Eunice and Sergeant Shriver became my heroes." Eunice Kennedy Shriver was the sister of John F. Kennedy, and mother-in-law to Schwarzenegger. Sergeant Shriver is husband to Eunice and father-in-law to Schwarzenegger. Schwarzenegger cannot run for U.S. president as he is not a natural-born citizen of the United States. Schwarzenegger is a dual Austrian and United States citizen. 98. He has held Austrian citizenship since birth and U.S. citizenship since becoming naturalized in 1983. Being Austrian and thus European, he was able to win the 2007 European Voice Campaigner of the Year award for taking action against climate change with the California Global Warming Solutions Act of 2006 and plans to introduce an emissions trading scheme with other U.S. states and possibly with the EU. Governor Schwarzenegger during his visit to Naval Medical Center in San Diego, July 2010. Because of his personal wealth from his acting career, Schwarzenegger did not accept his governor's salary of $175,000 per year. Schwarzenegger's endorsement in the Republican primary of the 2008 U.S. presidential election was highly sought. Despite being good friends with candidates Rudy Giuliani and Senator John McCain, Schwarzenegger remained neutral throughout 2007 and early 2008. Giuliani dropped out of the presidential race on January 30, 2008, largely because of a poor showing in Florida, and endorsed McCain. Later that night, Schwarzenegger was in the audience at a Republican debate at the Ronald Reagan Presidential Library in California. The following day, he endorsed McCain, joking, "It's Rudy's fault." In reference to his friendships with both candidates and that he could not make up his mind. Schwarzenegger's endorsement was thought to be a boost for Senator McCain's campaign. Both spoke about their concerns for the environment and economy. In its April 2010 report, progressive ethics watchdog group Citizens for Responsibility and Ethics in Washington named Schwarzenegger one of 11 worst governors in the United States because of various ethics issues throughout Schwarzenegger's term as governor. Governor Schwarzenegger played a significant role in opposing Proposition 66, a proposed amendment of the Californian Three Strikes Law, in November 2004. This amendment would have required the third felony to be either violent or serious to mandate a 25 years to life sentence. In the last week before the ballot, Schwarzenegger launched an intensive campaign against Proposition 66. He stated that it would release 26,000 dangerous criminals and rapists. Although he began his tenure as governor with record high approval ratings, as high as 65% in May 2004, he left office with a record low 23%, only 1% higher than that of Gray Davis. When he was recalled in October 2003. Death of Luis Santos. Main article, Death of Luis Santos. In May 2010, Esteban Nunez pleaded guilty to involuntary manslaughter and was sentenced to 16 years in prison for the death of Luis Santos. Nunez is the son of Fabian Nunez, then California Assembly Speaker of the House and a close friend and staunch political ally of then-Governor Schwarzenegger. As a personal favor to a friend, just hours before he left office, and as one of his last official acts, Schwarzenegger commuted Nunez's sentence by more than half. To 7 years against protocol, Schwarzenegger did not inform Santos' family or the San Diego County prosecutors about the commutation. They learned about it in a call from a reporter. The Santos family, along with the San Diego District Attorney, sued to stop the commutation, claiming that it violated Mossy's law. In September 2012, Sacramento County Superior Court Judge Lloyd Connolly stated, based on the evidentiary records before this court involving this case, there was an abuse of discretion, this was a distasteful commutation. It was repugnant to the bulk of the citizenry of this state. However, Connolly ruled that Schwarzenegger remained within his executive powers as governor. Subsequently, as a direct result of the way the commutation was handled, Governor Jerry Brown signed a bipartisan bill that allows offenders' victims and their families to be notified at least 10 days' notice for any commutations. Nunez was released from prison after serving less than 6 years. Allegations of sexual misconduct. During his initial campaign for governor, allegations of sexual and personal misconduct were raised against Schwarzenegger, dubbed Gropegate. Within the last 5 days before the election, news reports appeared in the Los Angeles Times recounting allegations of sexual misconduct from several individual women, six of whom eventually came forward with their personal stories. Three of the women claimed he had grabbed their breasts, a fourth said he placed his hand under her skirt on her buttock. A fifth woman claimed Schwarzenegger tried to take off her bathing suit in a hotel elevator, and the last said he pulled her onto his lap and asked her about a sex act. Schwarzenegger admitted that he has behaved badly sometimes and apologized, but also stated that a lot of what you see in the stories is not true. This came after an interview in adult magazine We from 1977 surfaced, in which Schwarzenegger discussed attending sexual orgies and using substances such as marijuana. Schwarzenegger is shown smoking a marijuana joint after winning Mr. Olympia in the 1975 documentary film Pumping Iron. In an interview with GQ magazine in October 2007, Schwarzenegger said, "Marijuana is not a drug. It's a leaf. My drug was pumping iron, trust me." His spokesperson later said the comment was meant to be a joke. British television personality Anna Richardson settled a libel lawsuit in August 2006 against Schwarzenegger, his top aide, Sean Walsh, and his publicist, Cheryl Maine. A joint statement read, "The parties are content to put this matter behind them and are pleased that this legal dispute has now been settled." Richardson claimed they tried to tarnish her reputation by dismissing her allegations that Schwarzenegger touched her breast during a press event for the sixth day in London. She claimed Walsh and Maine libeled her in a Los Angeles Times article when they contended she encouraged his behavior. Citizenship. Schwarzenegger became a naturalized U.S. citizen on September 17, 1983. Shortly before he gained his citizenship, he asked the Austrian authorities for the right to keep his Austrian citizenship, as Austria does not usually allow dual citizenship. His request was granted, and he retained his Austrian citizenship. In 2005, Peter Pilz, a member of the Austrian parliament from the Austrian Green Party, unsuccessfully advocated for parliament to revoke Schwarzenegger's Austrian citizenship due to his decision not to prevent the executions of Donald Beardsley and Stanley Williams. Pilz argued that Schwarzenegger caused damage to Austria's reputation in the international community because Austria abolished the death penalty in 1968. Pilz based his argument on Article 33 of the Austrian Citizenship Act, which states, "A citizen, who is in the public service of a foreign country, shall be deprived of his citizenship if he heavily damages the reputation or the interests of the Austrian Republic." Pilz claimed that Schwarzenegger's actions in support of the death penalty, prohibited in Austria under Protocol 13 of the European Convention on Human Rights, had damaged Austria's reputation. Schwarzenegger explained his actions by pointing out that his only duty as governor of California with respect to the death penalty was to correct an error by the justice system by pardon or clemency. If such an error had occurred. Environmental record. On September 27, 2006, Schwarzenegger signed the Global Warming Solutions Act of 2006. creating the nation's first cap on greenhouse gas emissions. The law set new regulations on the amount of emissions utilities, refineries, and manufacturing plants are allowed to release into the atmosphere. Schwarzenegger also signed a second global warming bill that prohibits large utilities and corporations in California from making long-term contracts with suppliers who do not meet the state's greenhouse gas emission standards. The two bills are part of a plan to reduce California's emissions by 25% to 1990s levels by 2020. In 2005, Schwarzenegger issued an executive order calling to reduce greenhouse gases to 80% below 1990 levels by 2050. Schwarzenegger signed another executive order on October 17, 2006, allowing California to work with the Northeast's Regional Greenhouse Gas Initiative. They plan to reduce carbon dioxide emissions by issuing a limited amount of carbon credits to each power plant in participating states. Any power plants that exceed emissions for the number of carbon credits will have to purchase more credits to cover the difference. The plan took effect in 2009. In addition to using his political power to fight global warming, the governor has taken steps at his home to reduce his personal carbon footprint. Schwarzenegger has adapted one of his Hummers to run on hydrogen and another to run on biofuels. He has also installed solar panels to heat his home. In respect of his contribution to the direction of the U.S. motor industry, Schwarzenegger was invited to open the 2009 SAE World Congress in Detroit, on April 20, 2009. In 2011, Schwarzenegger founded the R20 Regions of Climate Action to develop a sustainable, low-carbon economy. Presidential ambitions. The Equal Opportunity to Govern Amendment in 2003 was widely accredited as the Amend for Arnold Bill, which would have added an amendment to the U.S. Constitution allowing his run, as he was not a natural-born citizen. In 2004, the Amend for Arnold campaign was launched, featuring a website and TV advertising promotion. In June 2007, Schwarzenegger was featured on the cover of Time magazine with Michael Bloomberg, and subsequently, the two joked about a presidential ticket together. In October 2013, the New York Post reported that Schwarzenegger was exploring a future run for president. The former California governor would face a constitutional hurdle. Article 2, Section I, Clause V nominally prevents individuals who are not natural-born citizens of the United States from assuming the office. He has reportedly been lobbying legislators about a possible constitutional change, or filing a legal challenge to the provision. Columbia University law professor Michael Dorf observed that Schwarzenegger's possible lawsuit could ultimately win him the right to run for the office, noting, "The law is very clear. But it's not 100% clear that the courts would enforce that law rather than leave it to the political process." Business career. Schwarzenegger has had a highly successful business career following his move to the United States. Schwarzenegger became a prolific goal setter and would write his objectives at the start of the year on index cards. Like starting a mail order business or buying a new car, and succeed in doing so. By the age of 30, Schwarzenegger was a millionaire, well before his career in Hollywood. His financial independence came from his success as a budding entrepreneur with a series of lucrative business ventures and investments. Bricklaying business in 1968. Schwarzenegger and fellow bodybuilder Franco Columbia started a bricklaying business. The business flourished thanks to the pair's marketing savvy and an increased demand following the 1971 San Fernando earthquake. Schwarzenegger and Columbia used profits from their bricklaying venture to start a mail order business, selling bodybuilding and fitness related equipment and instructional tapes. Investments. Schwarzenegger transferred profits from the mail order business and his bodybuilding competition winnings into his first real estate investment venture, an apartment building he purchased for $10,000. He would later go on to invest in a number of real estate holding companies. Schwarzenegger was a founding celebrity investor in the Planet Hollywood chain of international theme restaurants, modeled after the Hard Rock Cafe, along with Bruce Willis, Sylvester Stallone and Demi Moore. Schwarzenegger severed his financial ties with the business in early 2000. Schwarzenegger said the company had not had the success he had hoped for, claiming he wanted to focus his attention on new U.S. global business ventures and his movie career. He also invested in a shopping mall in Columbus, Ohio. He has talked about some of those who have helped him over the years in business. "I couldn't have learned about business without a parade of teachers guiding me from Milton Friedman to Donald Trump and now, Leigh Wexner and Warren Buffett. I even learned a thing or two from Planet Hollywood, such as when to get out. And I did." He has significant ownership in Dimensional Fund Advisors, an investment firm. Schwarzenegger is also the owner of Arnold's Sports Festival, which he started in 1989 and is held annually in Columbus, Ohio. It is a festival that hosts thousands of international health and fitness professionals, which has also expanded into a three-day expo. He also owns a movie production company called Oak Productions Incorporated and Fitness Publications, a joint publishing venture with Simon & Schuster. Restaurant. In 1992, Schwarzenegger and his wife opened a restaurant in Santa Monica called Schitzy on Main. Schitzy literally means little treasure, colloquial for honey or darling in German. In 1998, he sold his restaurant. Wealth. Schwarzenegger's net worth had been conservatively estimated at $100 million, $200,000,142 after separating from his wife, Maria Shriver, in 2011. It has been estimated that his net worth has been approximately $400 million, and even as high as $800 million, based on tax returns he filed in 2006. Over the years as an investor, he invested his bodybuilding and movie earnings in an array of stocks, bonds, privately controlled companies, and real estate holdings worldwide, making his net worth as an accurate estimation difficult to calculate, particularly in light of declining real estate values owing to economic recessions in the US and Europe since the late 2000s. In June 1997, Schwarzenegger spent $38 million of his own money on a private Gulfstream jet. Schwarzenegger once said of his fortune, "Money doesn't make you happy. I now have $50 million, but I was just as happy when I had $48 million. Commercial advertisements. He appears in a series of commercials for the Machine Zone game Mobile Strike as a military commander and spokesman. Personal life. Early relationships. In 1969, Schwarzenegger met Barbara Outland, later Barbara Outland Baker, an English teacher with whom he lived until 1974. Schwarzenegger said of Baker in his 1977 memoir, "Basically it came down to this. She was a well-balanced woman who wanted an ordinary, solid life, and I was not a well-balanced man, and hated the very idea of ordinary life." Baker has described Schwarzenegger as a joyful personality, totally charismatic, adventurous, and athletic, but claims that towards the end of the relationship he became insufferable, classically conceited, the world revolved around him. Baker published her memoir in 2006, entitled Arnold and Me, In the Shadow of the Austrian Oak. Although Baker painted an unflattering portrait of her former lover at times, Schwarzenegger actually contributed to the tell-all book with a foreword, and also met with Baker for 3 hours. Baker claims that she only learned of his being unfaithful after they split, and talks of a turbulent and passionate love life. Schwarzenegger has made it clear that their respective recollection of events can differ. The couple first met 6 to 8 months after his arrival in the U.S. Their first date was watching the first Apollo moon landing on television. They shared an apartment in Santa Monica, California, for 3.5 years, and having little money, they would visit the beach all day or have barbecues in the backyard. Although Baker claims that when she first met Schwarzenegger, He had little understanding of polite society and she found him a turn-off, she says. He's as much a self-made man as it's possible to be. He never got encouragement from his parents, his family, his brother. He just had this huge determination to prove himself, and that was very attractive. I'll go to my grave knowing Arnold loved me. Schwarzenegger met his next lover, Beverly Hills hairdresser's assistant Sue Murray, on Venice Beach in July 1977. According to Murray, the couple led an open relationship. We were faithful when we were both in LA, but when he was out of town, we were free to do whatever we wanted. Schwarzenegger met television journalist Maria Shriver, niece of President John F. Kennedy, at the Robert F. Kennedy tennis tournament in August 1977. He went on to have a relationship with both Murray and Shriver until August 1978, when Murray, who knew of his relationship with Shriver, issued an ultimatum. Marital separation on May 9, 2011, Shriver and Schwarzenegger ended their relationship after 25 years of marriage, with Shriver moving out of the couple's Brentwood mansion. On May 16, 2011, the Los Angeles Times revealed that Schwarzenegger had fathered a son more than 14 years earlier with an employee in their household, Mildred Patricia Patty Bina. After leaving the governor's office, I told my wife about this event, which occurred over a decade ago, Schwarzenegger said in a statement issued to the Times. In the statement, Schwarzenegger did not mention that he had confessed to his wife only after she had confronted him with the information, which she had done after confirming with the housekeeper what she had suspected about the child. Bina is of Guatemalan origin. She was employed by the family for 20 years and retired in January 2011. The pregnant Bina was working in the home while Shriver was pregnant with the youngest of the couple's four children. Bina's son with Schwarzenegger, Joseph, was born on October 2, 1997, and Shriver gave birth to Christopher a few days before on September 27, 1997. Schwarzenegger says it took 7 or 8 years before he found out that he had fathered a child with his housekeeper. It was not until the boy started looking like him that he put things together. Schwarzenegger has taken financial responsibility for the child from the start and continued to provide support. KNX 1070 Radio reported that in 2010 he bought a new four-bedroom house with a pool for Bina and their son in Bakersfield, California. Bina separated from her husband, Rogelio, a few months after Joseph's birth. She filed for divorce in 2008. Rogelio says that the child's birth certificate was falsified and that he planned to sue Schwarzenegger for engaging in conspiracy to falsify a public document, a serious crime in California. Pursuant to the divorce judgment, Schwarzenegger kept the Brentwood home, while Shriver purchased a new home nearby so that the children could travel between their parents' homes. They shared custody of the two youngest children. Schwarzenegger came under fire after the initial petition did not include spousal support and a reimbursement of attorney's fees. However, he claims this was not intentional and that he signed the initial documents without having properly read them. He filed amended divorce papers remedying this. Schwarzenegger and Shriver finalized their divorce in 2017, 6 years after separating. After the scandal, Danish-Italian actress Bridget Nielsen came forward and stated that she too had an affair with Schwarzenegger while he was in a relationship with Shriver, saying, "Maybe I wouldn't have got into it if he said I'm going to marry Maria and this is deadly serious, but he didn't, and our affair carried on." When asked in January 2014, "Of all the things you are famous for, which are you least proud of?" Schwarzenegger replied, "I'm least proud of the mistakes I made that caused my family pain and split us up." As of July 2015, Schwarzenegger was dating physical therapist Heather Milligan, 27 years his junior. Accidents and injuries. Schwarzenegger was born with a bicuspid aortic valve. An aortic valve with only two leaflets, A normal aortic valve has three leaflets. He opted in 1997 for a replacement heart valve made of his own transplanted tissue. Medical experts predicted he would require heart valve replacement surgery in the following 2 to 8 years as his valve would progressively degrade. Schwarzenegger apparently opted against a mechanical valve, the only permanent solution available at the time of his surgery, because it would have sharply limited his physical activity and capacity to exercise. On March 29, 2018, Schwarzenegger had undergone emergency open-heart surgery. He said about his recovery, "I underwent open-heart surgery this spring, I had to use a walker. I had to do breathing exercises 5 times a day to retrain my lungs. I was frustrated and angry, and in my worst moments, I couldn't see the way back to my old self." On December 9, 2001, he broke 6 ribs and was hospitalized for 4 days after a motorcycle crash in Los Angeles. Schwarzenegger saved a drowning man's life in 2004 while on vacation in Hawaii by swimming out and bringing him back to shore. On January 8, 2006, while Schwarzenegger was riding his Harley-Davidson motorcycle in Los Angeles, with his son Patrick in the sidecar, another driver backed into the street he was riding on, causing him and his son to collide with the car at a low speed. While his son and the other driver were unharmed, Schwarzenegger sustained a minor injury to his lip, requiring 15 stitches. "No citations were issued," said Officer Jason Lee, a Los Angeles Police Department spokesman. Schwarzenegger did not obtain his motorcycle license until July 3, 2006. Schwarzenegger tripped over his ski pole and broke his right femur while skiing in Sun Valley, Idaho, with his family on December 23, 2006. On December 26, he underwent a 90-minute operation in which cables and screws were used to wire the broken bone back together. He was released from the St. John's Health Center on December 30, 2006. Schwarzenegger's private jet made an emergency landing at Van Nuys Airport on June 19, 2009, after the pilot reported smoke coming from the cockpit. According to a statement released by his press secretary, no one was harmed in the incident. On May 18, 2019, while on a visit to South Africa, Schwarzenegger was attacked, drop-kicked from behind by an unknown malefactor, while giving autographs to his fans at one of the local schools. Despite the surprise and unprovoked nature of the attack, he reportedly suffered no injuries and continued to interact with fans. The attacker was apprehended and Schwarzenegger declined to press charges against him. Height: Schwarzenegger's official height of 6 feet 2 inches, 1.88 m, has been brought into question by several articles. In his bodybuilding days in the late 1960s, he was measured to be 6 feet 1.5 inches, 1.87 m. A height confirmed by his fellow bodybuilders. However, in 1988, both the Daily Mail and Time Out magazine mentioned that Schwarzenegger appeared noticeably shorter. Prior to running for governor, Schwarzenegger's height was once again questioned in an article by the Chicago Reader. As governor, Schwarzenegger engaged in a lighthearted exchange with Assemblyman Herb Wesson over their heights. At one point, Wesson made an unsuccessful attempt to, in his own words, settle this once and for all and find out how tall he is by using a tailor's tape measure on the governor. Schwarzenegger retaliated by placing a pillow stitched with the words "need a lift" on the 5 foot 5 inch, 165 centimeters, Wesson's chair before a negotiating session in his office. Bob Mulholland also claimed Schwarzenegger was 5 feet 10 inches, 1.78 m, and that he wore risers in his boots. In 1999, Men's Health magazine stated his height was 5 feet 10 inches. Autobiography: Schwarzenegger's autobiography, Total Recall, was released in October 2012. He devotes one chapter called "The Secret" to his extramarital affair. The majority of his book is about his successes in the three major chapters in his life: bodybuilder, actor, and governor of California. Vehicles. Growing up during the Allied occupation of Austria, Schwarzenegger commonly saw heavy military vehicles such as tanks as a child. As a result, he came to develop an interest in large vehicles and became the first civilian in the U.S. to purchase a Humvee. He was so enamored by the vehicle that he lobbied the Humvee's manufacturer, AM General, to produce a street-legal, civilian version, which they did in 1992. The first two Hummer H1s they sold were also purchased by Schwarzenegger. In 2010, he had one regular and three running on non-fossil power sources, one for hydrogen, one for vegetable oil, and one for biodiesel. Schwarzenegger was in the news in 2014 for buying a rare Bugatti Veyron Grand Sport Vitesse. He was spotted and filmed in 2015 in his car, painted silver with bright aluminium forged wheels. His Bugatti has its interior adorned in dark brown leather. In 2017, Schwarzenegger acquired a Mercedes G-Class modified for all-electric drive. The Hummers that Schwarzenegger bought in 1992 are so large, each weighs 6,300 pounds, 2,900 kilograms, and is 7 feet, 2.1 m, wide that they are classified as large trucks. And U.S. fuel economy regulations do not apply to them. During the gubernatorial recall campaign, he announced that he would convert one of his Hummers to burn hydrogen. The conversion was reported to have cost about $21,000. After the election, he signed an executive order to jumpstart the building of hydrogen refueling plants called the California Hydrogen Highway Network, and gained a U.S. Department of Energy grant to help pay for its projected $91 million cost. California took delivery of the first H2H, hydrogen Hummer, in October 2004. Public life. Schwarzenegger has been involved with the Special Olympics for many years after they were founded by his ex-mother-in-law, Eunice Kennedy Shriver. In 2007, Schwarzenegger was the official spokesperson for the Special Olympics, which were held in Shanghai, China. Schwarzenegger believes that quality school opportunities should be made available to children who might not normally be able to access them. In 1995, he founded the Inner City Games Foundation, ICG, which provides cultural, educational, and community enrichment programming to youth. ICG is active in 15 cities around the country and serves over 250,000 children in over 400 schools countrywide. He has also been involved with After School All-Stars and founded the Los Angeles branch in 2002. Ozzus is an after-school program provider, educating youth about health, fitness, and nutrition. On February 12, 2010, Schwarzenegger took part in the Vancouver Olympic torch relay. He handed off the flame to the next runner, Sebastian Coe. Schwarzenegger had a collection of Marxist busts, which he requested from Russian friends at the end of the Soviet Union as they were being destroyed. In 2011, he revealed that his wife had requested they be removed, but he kept the one of Vladimir Lenin present, since he was the first. In 2015, he said he kept the Lenin bust to show losers. Schwarzenegger is a lifelong supporter and friend of Israel, and has participated in L.A.'s pro-Israel rally, among other similar events. Schwarzenegger supported the 2003 invasion of Iraq. Schwarzenegger also expressed support for the 2011 military intervention in Libya. Schwarzenegger Institute for State and Global Policy. In 2012, Schwarzenegger helped to found the Schwarzenegger Institute for State and Global Policy, which is a part of the USC Sol Price School of Public Policy at the University of Southern California. The Institute's mission is to advance post-partisanship, where leaders put people over political parties and work together to find the best ideas and solutions to benefit the people they serve and to seek to influence public policy and public debate in finding solutions to the serious challenges we face. Schwarzenegger serves as chairman of the Institute. Global warming. At a 2015 security conference, Arnold Schwarzenegger called climate change the issue of our time. -2016 presidential election. For the 2016 Republican Party presidential primaries, Schwarzenegger endorsed fellow Republican John Kasich. However, he announced in October that he would not vote for the Republican presidential candidate Donald Trump in that year's United States presidential election. With this being the first time he did not vote for the Republican candidate since becoming a citizen in 1983. Post-2016. In recent years, Schwarzenegger has been advocating for eating less meat, and he is an executive producer alongside James Cameron et al. Behind the upcoming documentary The Game Changers, that documents the explosive rise of plant-based eating in professional sports, in which he will also star himself. In 2019, while at the Arnold Classic Africa Sports Competition as an official, Arnold was attacked by an assailant in a flying kick. The assailant was arrested. Awards and honors. Main article, list of awards and nominations received by Arnold Schwarzenegger. 7-time Mr. Olympia winner. 4-time Mr. Universe winner. -1969 World Amateur Bodybuilding Champion. -1977 Golden Globe Award winner. Star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. International Sports Hall of Fame, Class of 2012. WWE Hall of Fame, Class of 2015, 234. Schwarzenegger Institute for State and Global Policy, part of the USC Sol Price School of Public Policy at the University of Southern California, named in his honor. Arnold's Run Ski Trail at Sun Valley Resort, named in his honor. The trail is categorized as a black diamond, or most difficult, for its terrain. A Day for Arnold on July 30, 2007, in Thal, Austria. For his 60th birthday, the mayor sent Schwarzenegger the enameled address sign, Thal 145, of the house where Schwarzenegger was born, declaring this belongs to him. No one here will ever be assigned that number again. Commander of the French Ordre National de la Légion d'Honneur, on April 28, 2017. Books. Schwarzenegger, Arnold, 1977. Arnold, Developing a Mr. Universe Physique. Schwarzenegger. Schwarzenegger, Arnold, Douglas Kent Hall, 1977. Arnold, The Education of a Bodybuilder. New York, Simon & Schuster. ISBN 978-0-671-22879-8. Schwarzenegger, Arnold, Douglas Kent Hall, 1979. Arnold's Body Shaping for Women. New York, Simon & Schuster. ISBN 978-0-671-24301-2. Schwarzenegger, Arnold, Bill Dobbins, 1981. Arnold's Bodybuilding for Men. New York, Simon & Schuster. ISBN 978-0-671-25613-5. Schwarzenegger, Arnold, Bill Dobbins, 1998. The New Encyclopedia of Modern Bodybuilding, Rev. Ed. New York, Simon & Schuster. ISBN 978-0-684-84374-2. Schwarzenegger, Arnold, 2012. Total Recall. New York, Simon & Schuster. ISBN 978-1-84983-971-6. Thank for watching and subscribing. See you next videos.